strategies to help build and develop self-regulatory skills. The fourth important principle I have learned from various projects is the systematic support need for self-regulatory skill development in a learning model. Basically, I'd like to ask you to consider designing a learning environment that can trigger and help your students learn to better manage their own learning. I can never overemphasize the importance of this need for a learning environment design. Let me give you some simple examples. One of the reasons why there is a high dropout rate in unregulated learning environment, such as online learning, is because such learning requires much higher self-regulatory skills. Unlike face-to-face learning in fixed times and fixed environment, online learning often gives students ample freedom to set own schedules, learn at own pace, and most importantly, at any convenient location without revealing much identity, and in the absence of face-to-face social presence or direct peer observation or pressure. A slogan for one of the for-profit universities was convenience, convenience, convenience. Convenient location, convenient schedule, convenient pace. The freedom with convenience is great for those who can self-manage own resources and learning. Such freedom with convenience would be an ideal learning atmosphere and environment for those who can effectively prioritize tasks in short and long-term time frames. Today, schools do not teach students how to learn better or manage own learning more effectively. Self-regulation is not an academic subject in today's schools. I believe it is as equally important as literacy or numeracy. Many students who are familiar with a spoon-fed style teaching, they perform poorly in online or unregulated learning environments where self-regulated learning is crucial. Those who are so anchored in the passive learning style throughout the K-12 education experiences often want the same style of learning experiences when they face higher education and beyond. This is why many of those who sign up to go to online programs fail to complete courses in many cases. I really don't know why schools don't teach students how to learn, how to manage own learning processes, set and track short and long-term goals, or split big projects into more workable, smaller pieces while reflecting on their own learning goals and learning about their own talents. Students are currently supposed to pick up these important skills somehow, somewhere, but schools. How about the for-profit education sector? What do they do and how do they deal with this? Some for-profit higher education service providers do a fairly better job than nonprofit schools on motivating and assisting students before and while they're enrolled in their academic programs. If for-profit education services do a better job in motivating students, then why they face a higher rate of attrition? Good question. That's because for-profit education services do much more aggressive marketing and motivating people to sign up. They emphasize the outcome, but not enough about the process or what it really takes to complete an online program. Also, they often enroll students who would not or could not stand traditional classroom settings. Many students who have not developed effective self-regulatory skills often struggle in an online learning program. On top of that, many adults have work and family commitments. When you face a lot of these challenges, many online students drop out eventually throughout the program. The only way to know if they are going to make it or not is to assess them on their self-regulatory skills for a certain period, not simply on their subject understanding. If they can prove that they are capable of managing unexpected events in daily routines and regulate their academic work successfully during the orientation period, they are probably more likely to stay enrolled when they move on to the regular online program. Here's the interesting fact. The price you have to pay is the strong iron will coupled with effective self-regulatory skills to be successful in online or unregulated education programs that offer, ironically, a a lot of freedom and convenience. I hope you understand that online or unregulated education programs are not for everyone in our generation. I give a lot of credits to those who complete rigorous bachelor's degree program completely online because I know how hard it is and what it takes to finish such programs. In the K-12 sector, some online programs provide students with daily tasks, checklists, milestone charts, and all kinds of features that show students and parents what needs to happen on a daily basis. In this way, young students are not too overwhelmed with the self-task planning or the monitoring on milestones all by themselves. How someone develops a self-regulatory skill? Is it something you automatically gain as you get older? Not necessarily. Those who grew up with helicopter parents, meaning that students who grew up with someone who always tell them what to do and how to do things in certain ways, often develop a tendency to depend on such directions and regulations for life beyond grade school years. It means that the parents are not giving their children opportunities to develop self-regulatory skills and learn to make their own judgments. Students need to experience success through own self-regulation. Students need opportunities to exercise, practice, reflect, and develop own self-regulation strategies. When students have frequent failure experiences, they tend to have lower self-esteem. Because many students fail to develop such self-regulatory skills, there are companies that provide additional motivation-boosting services or reward systems ready to be overlaid on top of your education program. So, how do you design your learning environment to address this important need? Engaging students to use task planning and managing tools, progress bar, team motivation tools, messages, and so on would be very useful. Virtual modeling may be another good strategy. Incorporating these features with not only email alert, but mobile messaging or social network-based motivation tools to remind and give a little emotional push would be quite useful. Overall, think about ways to involve and leverage technological innovations and social networking channels to support, promote, facilitate, and enhance self-regulatory skill development in a collective learning environment. In more open, connected world with increasing freedom in choices, pace, time, self-regulatory skill is more important. As a parent, teacher, and educator, give tools, tips, examples, but don't regulate their learning process, pace, and practice. Because if you do, you're taking away the opportunity from your students of building self-regulation strategies and leaving no room for them to grow academically in schools and professionally in the future workplace. Hope you find these points interesting and useful in your designs. Thanks for watching.